Morning each, or whatever. Second attempt last time. It failed me after running a couple of red lights that I didn't see. Oops. Never mind. So, it's another morning. It's raining out there, or it looks like it's going to rain out there. So I might as well do a rerun. Oh, train sim classic today. Click the drive button. Yes, it did respond. Was it quick drive? Was it career? I think it was standard. Nope, not standard. Definitely not workshop. Career? Where was it? Quick drive? Nope, did that one. Must be standard missions. It's forgotten what I was doing yesterday. What I tried to do yesterday. So let's start from scratch. Right. The port road, that's the one. Scroll down to find the longest, most tedious mission. Ooh, what's that one? Killer to London Road Mineral working. Ooh, don't remember that one. Anyway, that's not the one I want to do. I want to have another go to get it wrong again. Steam power this time. A Black 5. Over the whole route. From over there to over here. So Stranraer Harbour. Through to all the way to Dumfries. I thought this route went further than Dumfries. I thought it went as far as Carlisle, but apparently that's the full route. Where does that one go then? Yeah, it does go to Carlisle, but I'm not. Or am I? No, that's even longer. What are we gonna do? Nah, I don't like that class 37. We'll stick with this. We'll stick with steam. This is what I did yesterday. This is what I cocked up yesterday. Fresh attempt. I'll try and spot the red lights in time this time. Inconvenient thing with steam engines, some idiot put a boiler in front so you can't see where you're going. On a right-hand bend, it hides the signals, which is nice. Of course, one-man operation. You don't have a fireman looking out the other side of it. Yes, I know I am. Doobie-doo. Put the reverser in full forward, give it just a few percent, make sure the brakes are on. That's going to start warming up the cylinders. I'm guessing the cylinder cocks are open. If not, I will do when I get moving. There's no, doesn't seem to be an indicator for cylinder cocks open or shut anymore. It's got automatic fireman selected. There is a way of turning that off. I don't know what the way of turning that off is. So long since I played Train Sim Classic and tried to do things like that. Me fireman's stoking it all up. Can't remember the key for stick your head out the cabin, but I can click that and stick my head out the cabin. Red light, sitting there, building steam, getting ready. A minute or so to go. Oh, press T, open the doors, let the passengers on and off. That helps. gallons of water, that's good. Plenty of coal. Stick my head out the other side to watch what's going on. Oh, that's good, I can see the signal. What I'm going to do is let some break off so it doesn't take so long to release. Because as well as going through some red lights yesterday, I discovered I was running late. I couldn't keep to the schedule. Every little helps. Is it recording sound? Yeah. Okay. So Passenger aborted. Got a green light. Right. Add some steam. Release some brakes. This being steam, you've got two controls. You've got three controls, including the brake. You've got your throttle, which is that red lever there that's wiggling up and down. And you've got your reverser, which isn't just forward, stop and back. You can change the amount of forwardosity you've got. And the reverse is like a gear lever. The further forward you put it, the more force you're putting through the wheels. So it's like choosing a lower gear on the car. Oh, it's only 20 mile an hour, it's not 25. That's a good start. You've also got a different braking system. Come on. Brakes back to not self-lap, put the brakes into running, which apparently uses less steam than release. A little bit of throttle. That's adding steam to the steam chest. Just similar to what a throttle does in a car. The reverser, as I said, it's a little bit like a gear lever, as you'll see a little bit later on. We're now going up a slight hill, so it's a bit more power. Oh, 30 limit. Limit, so kill the throttle, add some brakes. Add more brakes. And release the brakes. Explain the semaphore signals as well, because this is about 2-3 hours, it's going to take a while. I'm going on to the main line, so we're leaving Stranraer, we're heading towards Dumfries via lots of places. And I might try and find a short run from Carlisle. So sorry, from Dumfries to Carlisle. Okay, so I'm going to open the throttle wide up. I'm going to bring the reverse back a bit, go to full throttle. That's too far. Set it. Right. The way the controls work on a steam loco is you let steam into the what's called a steam box using the throttle. So that's putting steam through to the actual driving mechanism. Your reverser changes the valve timing in the cylinders, and the further forward you put it, the longer the valves are open. So, and at lower speeds that gives you a lot more force. At higher speeds it wastes a lot of steam. So as you accelerate, you reduce the percentage, I'm pressing the wrong buttons, that's the brakes. You reduce the amount of percentage the valves are open, and it uses less steam, and it works at higher speeds basically, so it's like changing up the gearbox in a car. Something like that. So as the speed builds, you'll see that you're using more and more steam. This red dial on the right shows your boiler pressure. And if it goes red, the boiler pressure is dropping, so you're using too much steam. You're using the steam faster than the fire's generating, boiling, generating steam. So I'm now losing steam pressure slowly. So to stop that happening, because I've still got a lot of accelerating to do, I'm still going up a hill, is I'll bring the reverser back a little bit. So if I bring it back to about 30%, that's gone green. Steam pressure's building now. I'm starting to keep the pressure up. So I'm not going to run out of steam. Then the fireman starts topping the boiler up with fresh water. That uses steam. So whenever he's doing that, there's more steam being taken out of the system. But if he doesn't do that, it boils dry. So it has to be done. So it's a balancing act to drive the steam loco against keeping your pressure up. The automatic fireman's looking after fire pressure. I'm going to have to slow down now. So close the throttle, start pressurising the brake system, or dropping the pressure in the brake system. So I have a flying brake, and you can see the brake pressure dropping there. Once you've got the brakes to where you want them, go back to where it says self-lap, and that'll just keep the pressure in the brakes, or keep the lack of pressure in the brakes. Got a station coming up, so I'm going to keep the speed coming down. But I'm going to try and stop at the station, not before or after it for a change. Right, release some brake. So the brakes, the way the brakes work, you've got several positions on the valve. You've got release, which is letting air back into the system, letting the pressure go up until the brakes are coming off. You got running, which is where you want it when you're just trundling down the track. You don't want pressure coming off, and you want to reduce steam leakage. I'm not quite sure what the difference between running and self-lap is. I think I'm going too fast, too busy talking. Many brakes. Try and get to the end of the platform, because the train's longer than the platform. Come on, come on. Keep going. This is how I got behind time last time. Right. And then lots of brakes. I really shouldn't have gone past that signal. Never mind, it was green anyway. Right. Press the C button to let passengers on and off. Yeah, the brake valve release lets the air back into the system. Apply takes air out of the system and applies more brakes. Once you've got to the brake level you want, you can go to self-lap. Self-lap holds the pressure where it is. Running seems to do exactly the same. Don't ask me what the difference is, I haven't figured that one out. And release lets air back into the system. Or let's vacuum out, something like that. Okay, right. Lots of throttle. Maximum reverse, so it's like having first gear in the car, low ratio, so you've got plenty of power going through to the wheels. I've also pressed C to open the cylinder cocks. Let steam open the little valve, let steam out, blows condensation out the cylinder so you don't get a hydraulic lock. So for the first few rotations of the wheels, you open the cylinder cocks, let it blow the condensation out, then close the cylinder cocks to reduce steam wastage. Okay, we're going. Accelerating happily. I'm going to reduce the reverse, so basically changing up the gears. Going to full throttle now. I'm about 220 PSI. Don't want it to go much below that if I can help it. So I'm gradually, as I accelerate, gradually bringing the reverser back. Just to stop it using all the steam that's in the box. Eventually, if you take too much steam out, the loco can stall. Then you've got to sit there and just wait for it to boil up more steam. above 200, that right, that's the fireman just putting more water into the boiler again. Above about 220, it can lift a safety valve, and you'll hear it's the safety valve start to hiss, and that's just wasted steam then, so you really... As long as you're around about 220, you've got the boiler in a good place. If it goes up to 223, 224, you might as well open the reverser more and use more power, because the rest of the steam's just going straight out the straight up the top anyway, straight out. Just being wasted. Dumfries and Galloway. That is a whistle board that actually says whistle on it, not just a W on a little post. Nice noise. Another station coming up about a mile away. This is probably about as fast as I'll get on this. Right, off with the throttle, reverse it back to not a lot, just a little bit of, just keep the cylinders hot, and plenty of brake, because we've only got half a mile to go. Come on, more brake. These semaphore signals, if they're diagonal like that, it means go. If they're horizontal, it means stop. Just picture it as a barrier. Feather the brakes a bit, not much, because a bit fast, come on, please stop. Oh. Well, the train's a lot longer than the platform, so that's my excuse. And the coaches, oh, cut spot. That's a good stop, that one. Pity about the signal, but never mind. Signal's in the wrong place. Right, so while I'm getting ready to go, open the cylinder cocks. Just a couple of percent of, a few percent of throttle, just to keep the steam moving, keep the cylinder's hot. I'm releasing some brake, so I don't have to sit and wait for minutes. Once it's time to go, what else have I got to do? Wind the reverser back to first gear effectively, so I've got plenty of torque for setting off, and wait for the passengers to do their bit. One of them wandering around madly. Right, okay, good. Open the throttle, let the brake off. This seems to be incredibly high traction. This thing doesn't seem to do wheel spin, so seems to be able to open full throttle and think, no wheel spin. Not realistic, but who cares? Got a timetable to keep. Right, could have been basically first gear. You can see how fast the steam pressure is going down now, so I'm going to start bringing the reverser back. As I pick up speed, bring it back further. And kill the throttle, because we've got two horizontal signals. This is a red. Lots of brakes. Lots of brakes, please stop. Reverse back to full forward. A few percent on just to keep the steam moving. Reduce the brakes. Let vacuum in or air out or air pressure up or whatever it is. Let some break off. Let everybody stand up that's in the carriages that just fell over. Not the best of stops. And plenty of throttle. Let the brake out. Lid off. No. That's what I wanted to do. Close the cylinder cocks, that wastes steam as well. Here, the safety valve, the pressure relief valve relieving the pressure, as well as the fireman topping up the boiler. Oh, back to the 60 limit. Another stop, so I'm going to stop worrying about steam pressure and just keep the thing going. Commit brakes. A bit less brakes. Because we're on quite a hill. timing seemed quite easy sort of at this stage of the trip, and then suddenly it's, I seem to be running late, but I think it was because I was getting the brakes wrong and having to faff about trying to get into the right part of the platform, right? And reduce speed, come on, reduce speed, there we go. Inverter from a lower speed. Keep the thing going, it's going on up. Where the brakes work is that when you open that brake valve, you start to add brake pressure, and you keep the valve open until you get the pressure where you want it, and then you move it back to self-lapse. Yep, stopping early again. Where are we? 21. Can't get used to these brakes. That'll do. Cylinder cocks open, reverser at full, ready to go. Reduce the brakes a bit, don't need to be on full. That'll do for now, don't want anything moving while people are getting on and off. Long stop because I'm running early, which is nice. At this stage it's quite easy, then it gets a bit tougher later on, or I got it more and more wrong later on. Right, you can see the boiler pressure climbing because there's nothing taking steam out the boiler, and it'll get up to another 1 or 2 psi, and then you'll hear the relief valve open. There it goes. That's just wasting steam, but it's better than blowing the boiler up. If you've got it set to a manual fireman, then you've got to turn the blowers on and off, look after your water level, make sure the boiler doesn't hydraulically lock up or run dry. Turns into more of a challenge that way. And keep the fire stoked to an appropriate level for wherever you are. If you're going up a hill, you need to be stoking a lot. If you're going down, then you'll stop stoking and let the fire die down and just try and anticipate the next bit of driving. Time to go. Off with the brakes. On with the throttle. I'm surprised it doesn't do wheel spin. Takes all the fun out of it. Close the cylinder cock. Do more than 50 mile an hour to reverse fully open, doesn't seem to want to do it then anyway. Right, bring it back to about 40%. Yeah, higher speed. No steam usage. Ish. head out the other side just so I can see any signals. Been caught out once already. Got caught out last night a couple of times. I have to be working up with somebody else doing the fireman looking at the other side of the engine. So you don't have to keep on nipping from side to side to see what's happening. As I pick up speed, I'm just slowly bringing the reverser back, bit by bit. Just so I'm not taking too much steam out of the box, just keeping the pressure to where it is. About 220 is ideal. Now I'm using the steam to make it forward when this happened. And the fireman's using steam to put water back in the boiler. And I should have put that brake back into the running position, which I didn't. But apparently that uses steam as well. Right, fireman's stopped using steam, so I'm a bit more reverse, a bit more power. So it's actually a significant slope for a steam engine. But it's doing it nicely. But it was. A little bit more throttle. We're not far from the top of the hill. So once we're over the top and going down the other side, the steam pressure will rebuild anyway. crest on the top of the hill. Playing with the brakes now. A few percent of steam just to keep the cylinders hot. Back into running, bit of throttle, left reverter, because we're on the flat, I think we were last time I looked. Trundling along happily. Got 25 mile an hour limit coming up. I'm ignoring the 50 because it doesn't really matter because I'll be braking for the 25 anyway. Shut the throttle. Well, apply some brakes because we're going down a hill. And I'm speeding. An amber, yellow, whatever you want to call it. That one that isn't red or green. Right, these semaphore signals, like I said, right, you've got a diagonal on the left that's slightly lower down, turning off onto that. Straight ahead, you've got a horizontal red one. We're not going that way. Alright, releasing the brakes. Are we on the flat? We are. Black and white means that's the back of the arm facing the other way, so that's for the outbound train. I think. Right. A little bit of steam, keep us going. Excuse me. Right. Commit brakes, commit more brakes. We've lost more brakes, that's red. Don't want to overlap that, please stop. Please stop. Oh. That'll do nicely, sir. Open the reverser, turn the cups open. Tiny amount of steam, open the throttle just to keep things ticking over. Job's a good one. And relax, where are we? Kurt Cowan. I really should open up Google Maps and have a look at and see where all these places are. Got a few minutes to wait. Oh good, I can go and take my medication. I'm officially medicated. Actually, fireman's got the fire door shut. He's got control of that, I can't do anything about it. Damping the fire down because we're not going anywhere, we don't need all the steam. A handbrake. A coal bunker type thing. So, what we got this side, is that steam pressure? Or is that brakes? That's steam pressure. That one I think is steam pressure to the to make it go things. The steam chest for the cylinders. We'll be able to look at that and see what happens, see what gauges work and what gauges don't work when you start running it. These glasses are the level of water in the boiler. If it boils dry, things explode. If the water level hits the top, then you'll do some sort of hydraulic locking and bad things happen. So the fireman and the driver adjust it, open and shut the water valve to try and keep it around halfway full. All that changes if you're going up a hill because the water runs to the back, and if you're going down a hill because it runs to the front, so they've got to be aware of all that. Going through tunnels and things, got to stop stoking, shut the firebox door, or they'll end up, or bad things happen. Because as you go through the tunnel, things blow back, things blow up. So you don't want to have that firebox door open when you're going through tunnels. It's something like that. Let's just reduce the brakes. I don't see a gauge for the brakes. Most locos are it, but always up it. I might be the gauge for the brakes. Yes. That's the brake pressure system, so the lower the pressure, the more brakes you've got, so it takes steam or air pressure. Increase the pressure in the system, the less brakes you've got. Right, so I'm going to leave it with about half a brake. We've still got a red signal. We're waiting for a train to come the other way. Can't go yet. Still got a red. There is a button to press for let me go, but I know for a fact there's something coming the other way. Passenger camera, don't know what that was. What was that? Oh, alternate view, okay. Here we go, here's the train coming the other way. Got a green. So, release the brakes, you'll see that gauge climb. And let's see what the steam gauges do. Give it some throttle. Not a lot. That one doesn't seem to be doing anything. That's disappointing. That should go up and down with every stroke of the cylinder. Never mind. The cylinder cup. Many power. Against the amount of steam. Limit. The moment the back end of the train passes out. There we go. Some major acceleration. Big hill coming, so I'm going to need steam pressure for that. I bet the reason it's dropping is for the safety of the relief valves open. Yeah, there we go. Seems to be good for the reverser. And then just play it on the throttle. Stranraer is one of these places from my childhood that I remember the name, but I can't really picture the place anymore. It's too many years ago. A regular visitor to most of these places as a child. Back when dinosaurs ruled the earth. Have a look through this side, make sure I'm not missing signals. I'm doing something better today. Put that back to the running position, where it should be. Less steam usage. Holding 60 a lot better than I was yesterday. I don't know why, I don't know what I'm doing different. Well, maybe just the train's in a good mood. I'm going to kill the throttle and get ready on the brakes. Going into a downhill. Off with the throttle. On the brake. Not that much. See what that does. That's holding speed nicely. Ish. Right, the throttle's closed. He's not taking water, the fish is dropping. Oh, it's because the relief valve's open, that's what all the hissing's about. Right, a little bit more brake. I think in the running position, maybe it just lets the air vacuum build or reduce or whatever it does. No, it does. It's happy there. It's in a happy place. Keep the speed up. Still got over a mile. One in 88. Yeah, significant slope. Now it's less. Start reducing speed, I think. ETA, 12:51, so ahead of schedule still. Bit more brake. We've got a 15 mile an hour speed limit coming up fairly rapidly. Didn't even look at those signals. Come on. Kill the speed. Ignoring that 40 limit because I know there's that 15 coming up. Right, put up the signal speed. We've got to go. I'm down to 15, so I'll just let the brakes off. Yes, we've got a green. Those signals are all the trains going in the other direction because we're unseeing the black and white back end of them. So we can ignore those. Right. Do some stopping. Place. Right, we've got a green signal. Not finished loading passengers yet. Let's start releasing some brakes. Okay, alright, brakes off, power on. That's not realistic, but never mind, who cares. Close the cylinder cocks. In the reverse back. Downhill, so once I've got the speed up, I'm going to kill the throttle. Hello, big boy. Oh, the cats are back. see, Merlin. Really could do without your ass in the way of the screen. I can't see what I'm doing. Off you get, buddy. Off you get. Thank you. Nicely. Slow down again. And it breaks. back, when it goes down to 40, only the other time. Still ahead of schedule. That's nice. So far, so good. Get ready with the brakes. Try and catch sight of the next signal. More reverter for lower speed. Determined not to miss any red signals this time. More reverter. Pulling right down. Going to get switched off to the left. I'm going to go. Yeah, too fast. Missed that speed. Fighting well and then forgot about it. Doing a grand job. When I close the throttle, there's a delay before the power stops. That's because it's got to use the steam up that I've put in the steam chest. It takes a wee while. Oh, come on. No, don't stop short. Come on. Keep going. Don't keep going. Alright, that'll do there. Sorry, guys. That was terrible. Well, there's plenty of time for the passengers to struggle up and down the train. The joys of steam. The joys of not being very good at it. So this is Freetown. That I know nothing about. Appears to be a field. Look, sidings, freight tracks, trees in the way. This seems to be a yard. Don't see any village. Yeah. Okay. And as for me stopping short, oh dear, look at that. Well, at least half the train's on the platform. Sorry, guys. Takes the brakes a long time to apply, and once you apply them, it takes them a long time to come back up again. Well, you can apply them fairly quick, but releasing them takes a while. So if you do what I did, put them too much too fast, you stop and you can't do anything about it. But once you're stopped, people start opening doors and jumping out, so you'd better, once you stop, you better stay stopped. Or it gets entertainingly messy. I saw in real life somebody get out of, one of the old HSTs, at about 20 mile an hour. They were late getting off the train there, flung the door open, got off. It's quite entertaining. No blood was spilt, but people were startled. I don't think the conductor or the driver were best pleased. Deep house asleep. Ooh, remember that other kid. Right. No wheel spin, so let's just go for full throttle. There you go. Come on. You have lift off. To balancing how much trying to get as much power out of it without taking too much steam out of the boiler again. Because 177, that's a proper up. If you take too much steam out of the boiler, you'll end up with no steam in the boiler, running out of motive power, and you'll stall out and have to sit there and boil some more water. So you try and keep the pressure up as much as you can. Hill, this one. sacrifice some speed to get some steam to keep the speed up. But I'll be stopping shortly anyway. Don't sacrifice that much. Yellow. Off the power. Commit brake. I will look out the other side to see if I can see the signal. Red lights and make sure I don't overlap it. Restart. But not yet. Try and creep up to the light. I'll do. Pressure relief valve is relieving pressure. As it does. Yes, it is. There are quite a bunch of stops, yeah. No, continue, do not stop. Let me make that go out. Press F1 again, that's the one. Right. Start reducing brake. Open the cylinder cup. And wait. Obviously the station for Gatehouse and Fleet is not in the village. Because I seem to remember the village being bigger than that. Don't see many signs of it apart from a couple of hooses. Right, let's get back to stick my head out the cab cam. here on top of the engine. Thank you. Tail. There's a thing. Right, there we go. Turn the cocks are open, brakes are off. Loads of power, because wheel spin doesn't exist in this universe. Back off on the reverser. Back off on the throttle until we get out of this speed, out of the 20 mile an hour limit. Oh, don't speed, don't speed, don't speed. Going downhill from here. Management. fill the throttle and commit brakes. Okay. Seems quite steady braking. Half a mile till the speed limit drops. Don't have a arrival time for the next thing because it's only a passing through gate thingy. Let's drop it down to 40. Downing.
brake. Two more brake. And a bit more brake. And not that much brake. Trundling along southwestern Scotland, it's not bad. Some huge boulders, can't remember them in southwestern Scotland, but alright. Not many behind you. More brake. We've got an ex-New Galloway next. Slightly annoyed that this doesn't have to go all the way down to Carlisle. When they're making these scenarios, I seem do not like you having the whole run of the track, which really annoys me. I like to do an end-to-end. Maybe you've got to do it in installments. I don't like this split up into bite-sized chunks bit. Right, stop thinking about slowing down a bit more. While we're doing time, we've got 4 minutes. 4 minutes ahead of schedule, according to that. Estimated time of arrival, 30:34. Don't need to be there till 13:38, so no hurry. Probably a good idea to slow down then. These yellow signals are like an ahead advance warning of what's to come. There's something on the track ahead. More brake. About. Oh, the 172 down to it. Okay, so it's going downhill a lot. I didn't realise.
Just for a change, I'm going to try and get up near enough in space. That'll do. Press T to let people get on and off. Maximum the doobie-doo. Open the water. Reduce the brakes. Self-lapse, probably safer than running. Still don't really understand the difference. Oh, go away, John. Morning, John.
Good morning, how are you this morning?
Alive.
Just alive?
Yeah.
Are you at home?
Yeah.
And available?
Available. Available for what?
Okay. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, I think that's a red ahead of us. Or is that a red for the signal? Yeah, it's a red for the siding. And relax. Click that on the other screen. Oh, the sim disappears, that's nice of it. Try again. That brings that back up there. That's different. Okay. Back to the sim. Yes, continue. We've got a fair old way to go. 1338. About an hour left. Just trying not to hit red lights. Quiet. Vaguely hear the bird song. Did I open the cylinder cocks? I think I did. A wee bit of steam coming out, so I think so. Yes. Turn the box to open. Oh, you can actually hear them. Didn't realise that. Yep, that's them open. That's them closed. Open. Closed. And that's the release valve. We've got a green, nothing just about, there we go, next stop. Dolly Parton. Bottle on, break off. We're off. Jump back to run. Straight away, oh, we're still going down a hill, so yeah, getting the speed in. Try and get the brakes right. Timetable suddenly starting to get tighter. At least I think that's what happened yesterday. Suddenly you've got to get going and get going rapidly. Option again. Come on. Let the brakes off. Oh, it's a bridge. So I can't do much acceleration once you get out of that speed limit. And the rest than half a mile from the station. Not bad. 410, 43. Yeah. 2 seconds late. That one to Matt, down to that. Soon the cock's open. From here on, it gets a bit desperate trying to keep on to schedule, as it did yesterday. Where am I now? Parton. Never heard of it. Outside the train sim, never heard of it. Okay, let's go. Since it won't spin the wheel, let's not stand on ceremony, let's just get going. Like I said, manual fireman, make sure it's well stoked and stop taking water when I want it for acceleration. That'll do. Shut the cylinder top, that would help. Rather more than that. Ooh, this one's got a church and everything. took my head off. Signal the head screen or up or something. Next, off with the brakes, on with the what's it. Go to cylinder cocks. Brakes back to running. Steam chest empty, so throttle basically off. Still seems a bit living captain brother, blah blah blah. Beams, etc. A bit more reverter. Thank you. wanged it up to full crap. Full crap. But not for long. Too much reverser on you and too low a gear basically, and that limits the speed. So notch the reverser back a bit and you get some more mile an hour. Apologise to the passengers. I'm getting a bit shook up this time, but I didn't write the timetable. And I didn't invent the kettle. Timing wise, oh, not bad, got 30 seconds to actually get alongside, get moored up at the platform. It's time to stand up again. Right. Oh, nearly. First carriage is just a bit too far. And that looks a lot longer than the green line on the where you are graph. Never mind. Who cares? Right. Big that. Open the cylinder cup, start backing the brake off, little bit of steam through, ready to go. Braking running, holding steady. And timing was almost right, I think. Doing a better job than I did yesterday, he says. I'll probably crash into something next. Well, this little cat that's standing on top of the computer will hit a reset button or an on-off button. Happens all the time. I say that's not meat chopping, is it? Where'd that come from? Oh, there we go. This I didn't think I'd stuck the thing that far out of the platform, but obviously I did. Yeah, oh well. One of these days I'll get it right. Not on camera though, no doubt. I don't remember a thing about Dolby. Just a name from my childhood. Close them up, chocks. Wind back the reverser. Or I won't get any speed up. Somewhere in Scotland, brakes there, just got me over speeding. That warning signal was at green, so the next proper signal should be at green, hopefully. Got the other side. Oh. Do one of the hill things and going down. like this job. One of these days, we'll do it for real. If I still got, well, whatever tracks left. Not sure how much that still exists. I'm not sure where it goes after Dumfries, whether this even... Oh, there we go, 6 mile an hour left. It might stop after Dumfries, maybe it's impossible to do this run again. Without a lot of walking. Past their feeding track. Alright, start the decent speed. Shot again. Off you do. What's that look like? Oh, would you look at that? Right on the end of the platform. Oh, perfect. So the wee green line. And the graphy thing is in the wrong place. Now we've got 10:04. I've really got time to feed the cats. Sorry, my friend, you'll have to. What have you got on your nose? What have you got on your nose? What's that? Is that a wee snotter? Do the cat food thing very quickly. Let's just get going. If we can get one too much longer, my bladder won't hold out. Didn't even show up on the mapping thing. So many sort of strange things take place in this year's train. Ancient train, so. Stopping up shortly, very shortly. Time in hand this time. There, but it reckons I'm 2 minutes behind now. Okay, here we go. Very rapidly. Off we go. The dungeon. No idea. bring the reverser back. Pick the steam up. Get the best that I can out of it. Signal for his own for a while. Stop it half a mile. You'd know that he overshoots. No way the time got a bit squiggly last time. No way I slept that far. Right, so we're on big thrust, ready for maximum throttle, ready to release the brakes. Okay. Let's go. Ignoring all the nice speeds, just full throttle. Manual fireman working at its best, you won't get to wait much more time up. on approaching. That way. Easy as a hook, the train driver looks a little bit. The stop is murder, but the brake lever works nicer. Come on. Green. Okay, let's go. Beans have been given. About 2 miles to the next one. Got to be getting near the end of this now. I'm hungry. About a mile to go, two loads of brake, a bit of a hurry. signal. Looking good. Looking clear ahead. I should probably have honked at that level dropping. Seems to be trying to optimise my speed and stuff. Oh, okay. 0.6 of a mile, let's start braking. Keep going, come on. Keep going. Don't stop. Right, get that off the boot. We're running late. Got my foot and stuff about. You're not totally on the platform, and I'm not, even though the signal's there. If you're not totally on the platform, it takes longer to load and unload. Makes sense. Right, that's all down. At least it's not telling me I'm late just yet. There's no way the signal should be that close to the platform. Because that's now lined up. That's just wrong. Thank you. green. Another signal that doesn't appear on the nappy doo-rail. Signals because I got caught out last time I tried this. I tried running this last night and a couple of spads and that was me done. It failed me. Downhill and I've left it late. I'm struggling. That says there's a signal there somewhere. Can't, oh, there it is, a green one. Nice yuppie one for a change. I don't know how you make up any more time there. I've gone off these brakes. I used to like that type of brake, but... Right, so I've stopped short again. Slow stop. Yeah. God damn it. Gets to be a challenge this. I'm starting to think this might be a fail, but I haven't gone through any reds yet. So maybe I'll get hurt. Certainly my timing's not going to plan. Definitely going to bank, it's 25 past 12 and I haven't had my lunch yet. And my timing's definitely off. Right, so big bottle, ready for that. Start releasing the brake, there we go. Next stop, Dumfries. Right. Come on, let the rest of the brakes off. Come on, come on, come on. Come to daddy. Let's go. Mile left and completed the last stop. My memory tells me I'll be very careful with the signals on this next bit because this is where I got it wrong last time. right-hand side. Too much reverser on. That's irritating. And we're getting to the 40 limit, so haven't got much speed to kill. That looks like an amber ahead. I missed that last time. No wonder I went hammering into the next signal. So I'm going to kill some speed and keep an eye out. Still go horribly wrong. Go through an amber, expect the next signal to be red. So you've got to be ready to stop. And you should be down to sort of 30-35 mile an hour. Max. That looks, there we go, there's the red. This is what we got in the yacht, son. Got caught out by that one. Went straight through that last time. Ended up following him on the track. No signal between us, and that's a bad thing. Bad things aren't good. Right, so open the cylinder cocks. Get ready for a green. Almost complete. Wonder if it'll give me a you've passed. Come on. That's why there's no timing, I suppose. Come on. Oh, did I miss a station last time? Not quite. You gonna give me a green? I want my green, I'm hungry. I want my lunch. Got things to do. That's a whole morning wasted. Well, wasted. Come out. And start creeping up to it. That traffic light. So you can startle and wake him up. Okay, now I'm bored. I've traced the signal, but I can't remember the button for tracing the signal. I thought it was G, but nothing seems to be happening. Maybe you've got to wait for the guy in front to go through the platform and on. Hello? Hello. Ah. No. No way. It's not the button I wanted. That's it. Oh well, I asked. Not to wait for that next, that last, that. There we go. We've got the train. We've got the way ahead. I see another train approaching. There it comes. Junction coming, that's the line coming down from Glasgow. Not the West Coast mainline, the other one that may not be there anymore, I'm not sure. I think it was lifted. Into the platform, come on. Yep, the passengers out. That on. Maximum brakes, because our journey is done. Welcome to Dumfries. Welcome to my lunch. Wish I was allowed to eat nice food. Never mind. Better than last night. Right, good stuff. Thank you, and good night, goodbye, good afternoon, good lunch, whatever. Right, where's the record thing?